have forgotten your PIN on an Android phone like this one here, it's going to let you guess a certain number of times, and then it is going to lock you out. And if eventually you can't figure out your PIN, you are going to have to reset your phone. So I'm going to show you how on a rooted phone you're going to be able to do that. First, you're going to turn your phone off by pressing and holding the power button. Power off. Now, assuming this has already been rooted before, what you're going to have to do is you're going to have to reset the entire thing, possibly all the way down to the operating system, and then you're going to have to reinstall it. And it was such a frustrating experience that I decided I would make this video to show you how to do it. So it's going to shut off here. Now that the phone's off, we're going to power it on a special way. I'm going to press the up button here and the home button, and then I'm going to add in the power button. So I'm pressing those first two, and then I'm going to press this home button. But once I do, pay very close attention right here. You'll see a little blue message that appears just for a moment, and that's what I'm looking for to make sure that this is actually working right. Okay, I've got all three buttons down. I feel it vibrate. I'm going to let go of all three. Now you hopefully saw there's a little blue message that appeared here just for a moment. And now it's going to pop into the bootloader, and instead of being the normal bootloader, it's going to come into the recovery mode. So this is Team Win. This is the bootloader installed. A couple different bootloaders that you could have, but it'll be somewhat similar. So in this bootloader here, you can do several things. You can go in and back up your data to a storage card, and you should do that before you attempt any recovery on here. You can also try to wipe, and this says that in this default mode that wiping it will hopefully be the only wipe that you need. Unfortunately, it didn't work for me, and I actually had to do the advanced wipe, so I wiped everything here, and then once I was done with that, it didn't warn me that that would blow away the operating system. And so then what happened is when you click reboot system, it will say, mine right now it says that the device does not appear to be rooted, but actually what it used to say was you have no operating system. So if you get that message, then you're going to have to go back and reinstall the operating system. And now I don't think it'll actually let me. I actually have to get out of this menu and restart. I don't want to install, but yeah, it's going to reboot. So now that we have to reinstall the operating system, I'll show you what you're going to need to do. So I'm going to show you, if you go into install here, right now I'm looking at my SD card. And by the way, after you load something onto an SD card, this bootloader in particular is really stupid. It will not refresh itself. I had to completely reboot the phone for it to see new files. But I'm going to show you how to get a couple of things here. This bottom one here that says Veneer, that is actually the operating system. And then the OpenGApps ARM7-1, that is the all the applications that goes on top of the operating system. You have to get these two files on here. And then what you're going to do is you're going to click on the operating system, and it adds it to the things you're going to unzip. You can add more zips, and then you're going to pick the OpenGApps. So now there's two things, and then I would swipe to confirm the flash, but I've already flashed this one. Instead, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take you on a tour on my computer to show you how you find those files, because that is not easy by any means. I also want to show you physically on this device. So on this particular one, it varies, but on this particular one, in order to get to the flash card, you're just going to rip open the back, and right in here, this is the flash card. That's what you're going to put into your PC to download the files. And again, you're probably going to have to reboot your computer in order to get that. And also, I wanted to show you that underneath, if you can't figure out, you're going to need to know exactly what model your phone is. Because, for example, this on the back here, it says Galaxy S3. That is not good enough, okay? Because there's actually many Galaxy S3s, and that's the case with many of these Android phones. So it's going to be hard to see here, but this says SPH-L710. That is the model number that you need. You need to know that to that level of detail, as well as that it's Sprint. You need all of these. And that says that it's Samsung. And you need all that information in order to be able to find the operating system that will run in your phone. So let's switch over to the PC now.
You're looking for two files. One is a operating system and the other is a set of apps. And it's really an embarrassment how difficult it is to find these. So I apologize in advance. What you're going to have to do is you're going to have to go to this website, forum.xdadevelopers.com, and then you're going to have to find the right device. This is a terribly organized page. You know, there's really nothing on here to help you figure out where your device is. That's truly atrocious. So what you're going to have to do is go into your devices here. I know I'm looking for a Samsung. And then I know I'm looking for, I'm going to start searching for a, let's start out with Samsung Galaxy S3, and we're not finding anything. And if I scroll down here, it's just a bunch of ads, so that's not any good. And, you know, even after knowing where it is, I'm still not sure how in the heck you're supposed to find this. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the forums home. Okay, and I want to go to, you know, it's still hard. I need to get to all. We're at the forums home. All forums. Okay, click on all forums. Again, you know, this is absolutely horrible. So now it gets us to the slash all. Okay, we're not even close to being done. All right, so now if you have a top device, you can click here and you can find it. If you're in one of the newest devices, you can click here and you can find it. But what if you have an old device? Well, you're going to have to stay in this all, okay? Now, this thing is a mile and a half long. Let me just start scrolling down here. And so here's some random, just totally random, all sorts of list of devices. And because these things have numbers, and some of them are spelled out and some of them are not, it's really hard to find your thing. You know how many different Samsungs there are here? So if I search for Samsung Galaxy, okay, so here's Galaxy Core Prime. Nope, that's not it. So let's try adding in the S3. So you see that it mentions S3 here, but it didn't find it here because they use III. So let's try doing S3 that way. Now you see here's AT&T, T-Mobile, Sprint, Verizon, Samsung Galaxy S3. So that's a possibility. And here's AT&T, Rogers, Bell, S3. T-Mobile. I'm try to get this ad out of here. You can see that there's a million of these. Here's another set of S3s. Here's, I think we're back to where we were before. So I want Sprint. So hopefully this is it. Let's try Galaxy S3. And we don't want accessories. We don't want themes. We don't want general. We need the operating system. So maybe that's not the right one. AT&T, T-Mobile, nope. Samsung, okay, Samsung, T-Mobile, Galaxy. I'm looking for Galaxy Sprint. Okay, here's Sprint Samsung Galaxy S3. That's what I need. Boy, that took a long time. Now, I know I want the operating system. It's either going to be an Android development or original Android development. What's the difference? I have no idea. So let's click on original. Okay, so now we're in Galaxy S3 Sprint original development. And now you think, oh great, well we're getting closer. Well, kind of. But now we have to find the SPH710. And okay, here we go. This is actually looking more like what you want. SPH710. Now, what you need to know is that even after you find the SPH710, then there are a bunch of different, quote, brands for who's making your ROM. Again, it's just totally crazy. I apologize. So in this case, there's a group called Vanir, and they make a version called D2 Spur. And of course, this all sounds Greek to anybody. Unfortunately, that is what it is. That this is the right one, believe it or not, or at least one that will work. Now, that was a pretty crazy way to get here. So let me show you what you can do also. So let me the way I found this page actually was, let's try to bring up a whole new website. So if you search for SPH-L710 ROM. Okay, so first result here takes you to Forum XDA Developers. So if you click here, this is the exact page that I just found through that crazy set of steps. So I would actually probably go that route and try to find it through just a direct Google search. All right, so anyways, we found it. Let's go back and take a look at what's on this page. All right, so when I was looking through this, I found some places that the development was dropped or whatever, so it's unfortunately not easy to figure out how you know that you want Veneer and that you want D2 Spur. Unfortunately, there's just going to be a bunch of these, and you're just going to have to try them, which again is crazy, but you're just going to have to do that. Okay, so what they've done here is they've given you a couple of different places you can download them. I found this one was the only one of the three that worked. And you have to get this D2 Spur. So if you go here, there's a whole bunch of different versions. Nobody's telling you which is the latest, but you just need to figure out which one's the latest by the dates here. So this one is Android 7.1, and this is a date, October 18th of 2017. So this is the latest one. So this is the one you're going to download, which is the one I did download. All right, so that's part one. You're going to have to download that into your downloads file. Then the next part is you have to get apps. So I tried getting these apps here, but these apps, if you click here, this is a dead end. Like I was saying, sometimes you find dead ends. I don't know what threads closed due to op retirement really means, but I know that you couldn't get it there. So in general, you have what's called the OpenG apps. And if you come to this page, it will give you these choices here to decide which of these downloads you want. First, you got to figure out which processor it is. And again, this is not an easy thing for just a random person. So what I did is I Googled my phone, and then I looked up what the processor was. Let's see if it's here. Processor. So here I found that the chipset architecture is 32-bit Qualcomm Snapdragon. If you Google this, you will find out that is an ARM, not an ARM 6. It's not 64-bit. It's only 32-bit. So older ones are going to be 32-bit. Newer ones are going to be 64-bit. So I needed an ARM and not x86. And then for the Android version, if you remember back here, remember you have to look at the title here. So this says 7.1.2. That is the operating system version. So we grabbed 7.1, and then there's all these different varieties of what you want to grab, but I think Pico is the bare minimum to get the Google Play functionality. That's probably what you want to do. So I downloaded that. Okay, so then I grabbed those two and I stuck them onto my SD card, and from there you can finally reboot into the ROM.
So after you've gotten those files, you're going to want to put them onto your SD card, and then you can find them down here on the bottom. Now, notice that I actually had the wrong apps in here, and I'll show you that there is one nice thing here that if you install the wrong, so I installed the wrong one here. I tried to get G apps for OS 4.4. That's not going to work. But if you try to do this, it's actually going to complain. Yeah, it says there was a lot of information there, but it's basically not going to let you do it, okay? So that's good. So if you get the wrong OS or the wrong apps, so for example, the first time I tried installing the OS, I thought it was a 9300 because most Galaxy S3s are. And so I downloaded all that, and then it complained, hey, this is not a 9300. So that's how I figured out that I did not have a 9300, but I had an SPH L710. And then same for the apps. I thought it was a 5.0, and I tried a 4.4, and I finally realized it was the 7.1 here. That's the operating system. So that's the good news. If you get it wrong, it'll restore it. So it's eventually going to reboot into the operating system. You're going to have to go through a long process of setting up all these different things, and there are many videos that are good about that. So I'm not going to show you how to do that, but the hardest part of this is definitely how do you find these two files here. So I've shown you on the PC how to do that. The rest is actually a walk in the park. So good luck on installing your ROMs on your Android phone.